Black Hippie Radio.
There you go.
This is Bring Your A Game Sports Talk mixed with a little bit of live and direct. I got the homies down here and we chilling and we back for day number two for this special broadcast. Right now we live across Facebook. Connect with the homie LeVar Hamlins. He's off to my right.
Yo, what's
off to my left, I got the homie Jatim Young. And off to his left, you got Smokey D.
What's back going on? Again.
What's going on, fellas?
Man, I can't call
man,
it,
we
man.
Get it, man.
We here.
It seems like it takes forever for Sunday to get here. And it's going to take even longer for the next Sunday to get here.
I'm happy to be back down here with the fellas. So,
man, you know. But we got a host of things we're going to talk about. Yesterday, me and the homie Smokey D, we did a live show. So y'all can check that out. That was yesterday's show. This week, we're going to keep it going. Today we're going to keep it going. We got week three results, MVP candidates. We're going to pick three of them. The power rankers amongst the top five. So we talking about quarterbacks then, right?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Okay.
Hello, power rankers for?
Power rankers is for the teams.
For the teams.
For the teams?
Yeah, like okay. Who is our top five team?
Like, who is the best team in the league, your top three, based on performance to date.
Okay.
In the first
and then you got NBA preseason, which kicks off, well, the Bulls kick off this Sunday. I think other teams kick off like Friday, Saturday, or whatever. Prediction of Final Four storyline of the NBA, surprise teams. And then later on in the live and direct show, we're going to talk this Bill Cosby incident. Plus, a few more things as the conversation flow, man. We sitting down here. We chilling on this Tuesday. Don't sit back and have some fun. Over to Tim Young. We ain't got to wipe him down, man. We're going to be sweating and shit.
Oh, yeah.
So y'all can call in, man. Y'all can tune in. 708-328-8923. Man, what up? What y'all want to say something before we move on?
No, thanks for tuning in. You know, got a late start, but it's all good. We about to, as always, we about to go crazy.
Smoke Diesel, you cool?
Yeah, I'm all good.
Okay.
To the point.
Make sure you good, man. But we're going to go ahead. We're going to get to a music break, make it a short, and then we come back in, man. We talking sports. We talking bass football. We back to y'all here.
Big catch a cane, big homie, what it is? I'm taking a rap straight off of these niggas. Now, everybody wanna be the king of the South when they ain't running the damn thing with their mouth, no doubt. It's all good, y'all just stay in y'all opinion. But in the South and in the hood, it's understood without saying it's a given. And ain't cause of what I'm doing for a living. It's more because of what I do and how I'm living. Not to mention when I'm rapping, I'm just heard niggas feeling. And still chilling on Simpson and Center Hillin'. Made provisions for the click and continue keeping it pimping. What the crack was in the house, the record sale through the ceiling. So say what you want, do what you plead. But for fun, I shoot 22 from your shoes to your knees. I run a record label and a crew of G's. So niggas are coming look for you if I sneeze or even breathe the wrong way. You better do what the song say and be easy, else it'll be a long day.
Okay, okay. Money rolls in the pockets of my jeans. Okay, pussy niggas couldn't see me in the dream. I'm okay, top topic of all of your magazines. I'm okay, head of the body, leader of the team. I'm okay, remember I can get you blocked now. I'm the prince, shawty, don't get it twisted. Been calling shots, giving for my clothes existed. And still find words on my mama kitchen. You might see me by the purpose of the vision. I got soldiers on deck. Baby face flipping, what you know about that? I keep a bad printer with that burp top back. My jeans feeling tight, come on, I'm a stank fat. Player better know that. My neck got so much shit. Dangling big dick, big chain. Niggas keep on hanging. Got a Hollywood hoe and a brother be slanging. They be hating cause I'm famous, not what I was thinking. This for every young nigga thinking he pays me. Got the bank of your gold and this shit'll be nasty. I'm a state baller, falling out my old school classes. This crap got big bank, let's see if you can match.
I'm a king. I ain't crows in the pockets of my jeans.
I'm a king.
Pussy niggas couldn't see me.
Me the greatest. Number one hustler, I keep the street blazing. Yeah. If race don't sell, I drive them up to sell races. Why y'all cherry picking hustlers out here slaving? Can't shit, nigga, run deep in my veins. Pump
A-Game Sports Talk Radio mixed with a little bit of live and direct. Got the homies, the players down here with me. Chicago's finest, the homie LeVar Hamlin.
Yo, yo.
Big Ten's own. Jatil Young. And my 20-plus year homie. You run up on him, you might get shot. Smokey Dizzle.
He keep it
How
open.
You feeling?
Yeah, we looking like we got a broadcast interruption.
It's like Spreaker, follow us.
But yeah, oh, follow us on Spreaker most definitely, man. That's how we get paid. But we sitting down here, man. We chilling, man. We got a lot to talk about. Yesterday, like I said, it was me and homie Smokey D. We came across the airwaves and we was just talking about the Bears. You know, we had to talk about the Chiefs, and he like, I wasn't gonna bring them up, but I'm like, man, I give your
credit, man. I gotta bring them up.
You know,
you gotta bring them up.
So we talked about that. So now we got the homie LeVar. We got the homie Jatim Young. So I want to hear y'all whole take. And the first question that we're gonna come up, because we know the Bears got the victory. We know that. We happy. We 2-1. We sitting on top for now.
We are in first place.
That's big. Let's talk about first things first. What y'all thought about Mitch? Who want to go first?
Quarterback.
You know what?
We got to kick it off with the quarterback first. Then we're going to do overall team. What y'all thought?
No, I mean, he the quarterback, so he can go first. Yeah,
yeah. You know what?
Y'all quarterbacks.
You know what? It's like, the more I see Mitch, the more I question, do he really know this offense? Or is he learning? Because I don't see the progression from week to week.
I just don't think he's ready.
I don't think he's ready. But some of the things I am glad to see is that he went downfield more, even though he missed. You did take a couple chances. But the thing I question Mitch about is, does he really know this offense? And how well he reads defenses? Because I could count at least six times in this recent game whereas he made poor decisions because he locks onto one receiver the whole game, like whoever has the hot hand. This game, it's like he tried to go to Gabriel a little bit too much the game before. He went to Allen Robinson a whole lot, you know. He get a couple sprinkles with Trey Burton here and there, but it was just plays, man, he left on the field, man. And it's like, I'm looking at this team and I look at other quarterbacks. I'm like, any other quarterback that can read the defense and grasp this offense, I'm talking about we are a convincingly 3-0 team. And I'm talking about without question. So, I mean, I question a lot of things, man, you know, from the coaching and stuff, because it doesn't help Mitch out. But it's hard for me to get a pulse on Mitch. You know, on one hand, it's like his stats compares to Drew Brees' his first 15 games.
Right.
And then on the other hand, it's like his stats compare to Rex Grossman. So It's like, man, you stuck in between with, you really don't have a pulse on this guy yet.
I hate, you know, let me say this. I hate when people do that. They put them comparison. Oh, I know Drew Brees is a good quarterback. Fuck that. He great quarterback. But I hate that you put Mitch next to him through their first 15 games. Two different caliber of quarterbacks. You get what I'm
True.
Saying?
True.
Yeah.
That's why I don't like it.
True.
Yeah.
Like, not even in the same, like, not, right now, not even say ballpark caliber.
Off there.
You know what I mean? Like, I don't, I like Mitch. And this is why I like him. He's young. You know, he's your quarterback for probably the next, 12 years, you know, if he makes it.
He might not make it to three.
I don't think he gets out his first contract. Like, I have to see vast.
But he can run.
Right.
He athletic, you know, he's shown he had an arm.
He has the tools.
He's willing to throw it. Like, Rex Grossman couldn't run. And he was too confident. You know, obviously, you know, we didn't have a defense we had, we wouldn't have went to the Super Bowl.
Absolutely.
But he doesn't turn the ball over carelessly like Cutler and like Grossman do. Like, they just, like, you, oh my God. You know, you watch some of them highlights and some of them film, you just like, man, this is crazy.
He got in, what, last year? What game did he start? I mean, they put him in?
I think they put him in like week five.
Week five, week six, okay. And then you got a whole different offense now.
Because John Fox was the coach last year.
Right, so he's learning, and then it depends on Nagy on how he can just, you know, mold him into what he wants him to be. That's the most important thing. I'm not judging him yet severely because right now it's only three games, you know. So he might have to just get the jitterbugs out of there. You never know. He might be, you know, a decent, solid quarterback if he listens to his coach and tries to do what he wants him to do, you know. Because, I mean, Nagy has a couple plays, and he got a lot of plays that he's going to try to utilize his strengths for on, you know what I'm saying? So both of them being first year here, they got to work out the kinks and everything like that.
I just think because Mahomes' success and both of them came out the same year.
Mahomes is totally different.
That's what, and that's what people looking at Mahomes, that the Bears took Trubisky ahead of him, and Mahomes is running the same system that Nagy made. One thing I do like about Nagy, that he said the team that I had in Chiefs, with the Chiefs, is totally different from the teams I have with the Bills.
I tell you what, fellas, we're going to do this. We're going to take a music break. We're going to get a few technical things worked out real quick. Be back in y'all in a minute. We live across the L. We live across the Home in the Bar having a page, but we're going to get him in order real quick. Be back in y'all L. All
right, what's up, folks?
When I get knocked off in the studio, making noises at the bottom of my pride jar. Parlay the Caymans. Flew to Vegas just in time for the weigh-in. Fight night, MGM, vaporizer blazing. Ballet for the classics, trucks with armor glasses. Franchise players on a momentous occasion. Announced the fact we made it, tip a C-note to the waiters. Send a bottle to your table, it's a celebration. Rolling presidential, inauguration. Stones clear than the HD station. And you hating, if you'd have had one that's nice, I'd have told you congratulations. I stole home base while you was tying your laces. Your bitch gave out the dugout, smoked out the club. House. Welcome to the majors.
Niggas hoping I get knocked off. In the studio making them drop offs. Ducking them hip hop cop calls. Sometimes my finances in the bottom of my pot jaw. Sometimes my finances in the bottom of my pot jaw.
Certified dope on three coasts. Bread healthy, we toast. Trying to see the fam wealthy. The fam held me down when I needed it. Held me up when I couldn't reach it. Flashlight when I couldn't see shit. Saying my prayers, smoking my weed, listening to raw airs. With more pull in my city than the mayor. Smart, not scared. Hide up but aware and prepared. If them fools from over there ever came round, yeah. But we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. Audio drug lord with this music.
Niggas hoping I get knocked off. Damn. In the studio making them drop offs. Ducking them hip hop cop calls. Sometimes my finances in the bottom of my pot jar.
Yeah.
Sometimes I find answers in the bottom of my pot jar.
Spit up! Yeah, don't nothing move but the decimal. Every day above ground is a chess move. Don't let the little things stress you. If you can go without killing a nigga, you successful. Low key, like I'm riding with a whole key. But I'm just chasing these cookies with this OG. I don't do first halves, I need the whole fee. You want Jada, Kiss, or you want the whole me?
Which one?
And I don't be popping bubbles. If I ain't house shopping, I'm at the dealer copping doubles. Ain't where I wanna be, but I'm not far. Answers at the bottom of my pot jar. Light one.
Niggas hoping I get knocked off. In the studio making them drop offs. Ducking them hip hop cop calls. Sometimes I find answers in the bottom of my pot jar. Sometimes I find answers in the bottom of my pot jar.
Bring your A-Game Sports Talk Radio mixed with a little bit of live and direct. I am your host, the Black Hippie, down here with three other players. the homie, Tim Young.
Yes, sir.
Plus, yeah, homie, Smokey D, and also Chicago's finest, LeVar Hamlin, man. We sit back and we talk Chicago sports and more, and this time we mixed it up. And we're going to talk about things that's going on, you know, in the news and in life. You know, but that's later on in the show. Right now, before we had clicked off, we was talking about Mitch Trubisky, and people were talking about how they feel about him and, you know, how he look and, you know, and is he ready, is he not. And I told you my end of result is he really ain't ready just yet, man. But maybe I am jumping the gun because I'm one of them anxious fans that want to see better because we ain't seen better in a long time. I feel like that child, and I don't even mean to make a joke out of it, but I feel like that child that's at the orphanage just waiting on somebody to adopt them.
You like a Cubs fan that we waited so long for
the championship. Oh, it's a bad word down there.
Got it.
It's a bad word down there.
I mean, but that's happened. If you ain't won a championship in 08, we ain't seen a Super Bowl since 85?
Yeah.
I was about to say 81.
I mean, what's happening right now is...
I don't know how the Bears only got one Super Bowl with that team.
The defense is superior. Oh, we'll get into that, man, one show. I mean, you know, breaking down, watching that 3-30. Anyway, your defense is playing phenomenal, you know what I'm saying? So you want your offense to score points so it can balance out, man, and make you up in that top tier. So, of course, he'll be all up on, you know, Trubisky like that. And then with these other quarterbacks playing well, you're like, well, hey, Trubisky, man, you got your shot, man. Go ahead and do it. You got, man, stage is for you.
Well, you said a week ago that this defense is better than the 06 defense, right?
I never said that.
Okay, you didn't?
No, I never
said that. Who said that?
Because
I'm going to say this. This is the point I was about to make. If you switch Rex Grossman and Mitch Trubisky, do the Bears win the Super Bowl against Indiana?
Hell no.
Right now?
No.
So we still lose with Trubisky behind.
Yeah, what's the name just tore him apart, man. You know what I'm saying? That was.
But the Bears had him in check, though. The Bears had Peyton Manning. We kept giving him the ball back. Grossman threw two interceptions.
Peyton Manning was in check that game?
Peyton Manning didn't kill us. We threw two interceptions and kept giving him the ball back. If you keep giving Tom Brady the ball back, if you keep giving Drew Brees the ball back, eventually, like we did when we played week one, if you keep giving them type of guys the ball back, eventually, they going to burn you.
I don't know what game you saw, but I swear he picked them apart.
No, he did not. Because like, yeah. how much did we lose the Super Bowl by? Like, what, a touchdown or something like that? It was a close game. Rex Grossman threw like three interceptions in a row. Erlang and him kept stopping dude. And Grossman kept throwing the ball away.
I mean, you got the run. I mean, yeah, Devin
Hester. We had Thomas. Hester was killing these folks.
I mean, you know, he's phenomenal on special teams and stuff like that.
Hall of Fame.
Yeah. Well, Trubisky, no. They still lost.
So, even with Trubisky, the Bears would have lost the Super Bowl.
Oh, yeah. No doubt.
Okay. What you think?
He reminds me of a little bit of Grossman and Cutler mixed together. Like, that's what I see out of Mitch Trubisky, and I'm going to stick to it. Right now, I don't feel like he ready, and I don't feel like that a season going to be wasted on saying, what if. I say, week four, we going into week four, and we got Tampa Bay. Going into week four, and you got Fitzpatrick, like I told y'all, the real Fitzpatrick showed up yesterday. Cause Big Ben, he knew he had to throw guns with Big Ben. You know, ain't no bringing no six shooter to that party, man. You got to bring them big numbers. But that's gonna be a tough task. That's another quarterback he got to face. That's gonna be a tough task for him. Let's talk about this.
Okay.
Week one, he faced Aaron Rodgers, right?
Right. Yeah.
Should have beat him. They moved the ball. He had a C-minus game. You know, he had a C-minus game.
Yeah, he definitely did.
Week two, they had who?
Seattle.
Man, Wilson.
That was another C-minus game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I blame Nagy for a lot of those play calling.
I agree.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because he should have ran the ball in.
He didn't run the ball against Seattle.
Yeah, so... That ain't just on him. That's on the head coach.
So now we get to week three. Mm-hmm. Week three, you facing who?
Arizona.
Bradford and
Rosen. You got Bradford.
Yeah.
Which me and Smokey D talked about yesterday with Bradford. I say, Bradford he known for burning the best.
Yeah.
400 plus, four TDs in the sack. Man, he known for burning. Okay, then. What Bradford do? Hit off two quick touchdowns. Breakdown in the coverage. Nothing to worry about. My thing is like, okay, Mitch, you down 14. The defense ain't playing too well. What are you going to do?
Yeah.
He turned the ball over. He played stupid. And I'm like, what if we face a quarterback like Tom Brady, which we do have on this fucking schedule? We get down 21. The defense is only good to give us 7 to 10 points.
I mean, not only that, we got Jared Goff. We got Carson Wentz on the schedule.
I'm talking about that experienced quarterback that's going to pick you apart. Because, you know, Tom Brady hates to sit on the sideline.
Oh, yeah.
I'm talking about them experienced quarterbacks that's going in history. The ones you name, and they up and coming.
Yeah, yeah.
He can sling. He probably can get on any given Sunday sling with them. Yeah. You get what I'm saying? But we're talking about experienced quarterbacks.
Well, here's the thing with the Bears offense, and parts of it I agree with and don't agree with. Like, they definitely need to run the ball more. But the offense moves. They just don't get the ball in the end zone enough. And I think
they got a break but don't be in offense. What the fuck? Yeah. You remember Lowe had the break but don't be in defense? They got a break but don't be in offense.
And that's the
you
thing.
Get all the way down there but can't get in. What the fuck is wrong with you?
And that's the thing. It's a lot of offenses like that in the NFL. You know,
we're talking about this.
I know it's a lot of offenses, but I think once he gets out of his mindset, that's what I'm saying. Do you really know this offense? Because once you know this offense, then your focus is like, okay, I know this offense. I can start figuring out how these defenses are going to attack me in every single play of this offense that I know of. And you will have a counter on top of a counter on top of a counter.
Like, he didn't see that two-corner blitz coming. Remember that one when he got tackled and he got out of field goal?
He cannot read defense. He didn't see, like, he can't read defense.
And who in this, like, when they,
that is Jay Cutler all over again.
Do they stop talking to him in his ear? Because can't they say in his ear, you see the corner blitz?
They cut it off like 15 seconds on the play clock. So after that, everything is on you.
On him.
Right. That's why the play clock is always very important, because you get in and out. And then they'll give you some final instructions of what to look for to keep the audible out or anything like that if they give you that option.
Listen here, let me tell you something. Lack just said something, and I said, like, he really can't read defenses. That being able to read the opposition and how they setting up and everything else, that shows a different level of intelligence at the quarterback position. That's why when Sam Bradford threw them two touchdowns, I was like, whoa. And I was telling Smokey D in the car, I say, people think Sam Bradford is a bum and all that. I say, his only problem is he fragile and can't stay healthy. But as far as, like, Sam Bradford as a quarterback, very intelligent. He can break down deep. This is why he got the Heisman. This is what they forgetting. This is a former Heisman. And he saw where the Bears broke down at, and their coverages and defenses, and that's how he was able to hit them real quick. I don't see the intelligence of Mitch. And that's what I'm trying to get people to understand. I'm like, he's not ready.
But
that you can go out there and run all day and be athletic all day. And sometimes I used to hate when people talk bad about Mike Vick, but sometimes you seen where Mike Vick lacked certain intelligence at the quarterback position.
Yeah. Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
And
that's what Mitch lacks, that intelligence.
But he ain't nowhere near Mike Vick, though.
I know.
No.
But I just use that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Just to, like, break down my, you know what I'm saying, my whole logic.
Because Mike will be like, I don't know what coverage y'all is, but catch me if you can.
Mike will fuck him up.
Right, catch me if you can.
Right about now, Mike will fuck the NFL up, especially with the
rules.
Yeah.
You can't hit him.
Yeah, especially with the rules.
And,
go ahead.
Nah, but then.
But Mick like, and, Mitch lacks that intelligence.
And Mitch,
I see it.
But Mitch needs to, like, that's why I'm real curious at how they train these quarterbacks, because I seen the double blitz coming off and I'm like, oh, if you just got the ball over a little bit higher, the guy.
No, he ran and turned around twice and they sacked him. Like,
I know. I'm talking about the second one. When he threw the pick that Chandler Jones actually tipped. If he'd allowed that a little bit higher just to get it over, anticipated the jump. The safety was coming from the middle of the field. So it's like, now it becomes a numbers game and you have to start counting. And it's like, now you have to look at the steps, because the defensive back blitzing, they don't care. They're gonna pick a aiming point and come at you on that angle. So, and all they're looking for is to get that sack. So you're gonna have natural opens there. And it's like, if you got a slot receiver, you're either gonna have a linebacker close by getting them, or you're gonna have to have a safety coming from about 12, 15 yards deep to try to catch up to that slot receiver or that running back. It was early in the play, like you said, when he turned around two times.
And then they sacked him, both of the corners.
If you go back and look, Tariq Cohen was wide open on that
play. I saw the play before he even happened.
He was wide open. I said, all here, if he could just calm down. And a part of it, I've been there, and you'll be so amped up, and you'll be so geeked up.
You don't see, like, the
dude
sneaking up?
Yeah, but see.
I'm talking about when you're under the center.
No, you can see it. You can see it coming.
Okay.
But being in Mitch's position at one point in time, you get trigger happy with one particular receiver because that guy has shown you he can be reliable. But that's the wrong mentality, because defenses in the NFL will take what you do really good and they'll start to take that away from you and say, okay, find another way to beat us. And that's what the NFL is good at.
By week four, if he playing bad, Mitch should be on a quarter-by-quarter basis, and Chase Daniels should be warming up, because I watched Chase Daniels in the preseason. They can say preseason all you want, but listen here. The man looked more ready than Mitch. I'm not going to lie to you.
Yeah.
To me, he looked more ready than Mitch. Under this offense.
Oh, they played Denver.
He looked more ready Denver than Mitch.
They played Denver and Kansas City.
He was under Nagy, though, so he understands this already.
Yeah.
He did back up in the Chiefs.
Yeah.
Daniels.
Yeah.
So he already know how this offense gonna go. But I asked you yesterday, when Pace picked him in that draft, I'm like, did he know, or what did he see in this cat? Because, I mean, really, man, nobody.
I think Pace just like big arm quarterbacks.
He doesn't have a big arm. I mean, if you went with the
big. He didn't like Watson?
No, let's be honest. If you like big arm quarterbacks, McCombs your guy. Because he's got the strongest arm in the league right now.
I was at Kansas State. I saw him play in college.
Yeah.
And I said, this dude is
McCombs.
Nice.
McCombs got the gun, so it's not about the big arms.
McCombs went to Texas Tech.
Oh, yeah, Texas Tech.
I think he looked at how Drew Brees came along in that Saints process, because that's what his roots is in the front office. And he's trying to look at everything step by step about who mimics Drew Brees the most. And so far, you can see it. But I'm like, man, think about
Pray
this.
For Phillip Rivers.
Think about this.
He old, though.
But Phillip Rivers still got you. Listen, with this defense and them fucking receivers the Bears got.
Super Bowl contenders.
Phillip Rivers, two in a row.
Could get us a Super Bowl?
Two in a row.
Yeah.
I don't think Phillip Rivers want to leave L.A., though.
LA ain't gonna leave Phillip Rivers. Don't let Phillip Rivers go.
That's
yeah, like
just like Matthew Stafford need to get out of Detroit, but Detroit ain't gonna let him go.
Yeah, the kids with a home out there.
Then, like I said, if you look at Mitch, sometimes he hesitates when he throws. I'm like, I looked at him.
No,
and
that touchdown with the tight end from the Eagles in the first game. Yeah, when he was wide open.
Yeah,
and he didn't throw it to him.
Right. I mean, but that's the thing, Allen Robinson. He had locked on because Allen Robinson helped make a couple passes, so he got locked on to Allen Robinson. When you know the offense and you stay within the offense, then the offense looks beautiful, and then you can score a lot more. When you lock into one receiver and try to learn it through one receiver, because it's like when you get in trouble, I can depend on this receiver. You know what I'm saying? And if we're going to sit here and talk Jay Cutler, that's what Brandon Marshall was to Jay Cutler, and that's why we question his football intelligence to this day, because he locked on to one receiver.
Well, that's why I'm glad on Sundays I get to watch quarterbacks, because I'm watching Cam. I'm watching Drew Brees. I'm like, why are these guys so good?
Speaking of which, let's get into some more games, especially when we talk
Mahomes.
About. We'll get to him, man.
Hold on, wait. How you going to say get into some more games and we talking Bears?
Because we talked about Bears. Oh, well, we talked about Bears yesterday, and then we got into the tangibles and everything, digging in, but I thought we were going to talk about the other games.
The show says Chicago Sports Anymore.
So it's 30 minutes and 10 minutes for the rest of the games, huh?
Hey, man, your team going to get their little okay if that's what you're looking for.
No, I'm looking for, I want to talk about this Minnesota game and how they got their ass whooped, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, it wasn't steady, a good game.
You steady barking on Minnesota, and you tried to talk about it.
Who did Minnesota play?
They cut Buffalo caught.
What, this last weekend?
Yeah.
What more is there to say? They got their ass beat.
When you're an elite team like that, though, man, and then you spend all
the money. That's what they
you got Kirk Cousins, too. You pay the money to get Kirk.
But Kirk was so iffy in Washington.
But they paid him his money.
He wasn't iffy in Washington, man.
So he, you know, they got rid of Sam Bradford.
I thought he
got rid of Teddy Bridgewater.
Had more success than
Case. They got rid of Keenum.
Who was the wide receiver that was in Washington that Kilpatrick throwing to like every game, and he getting numbers? Jackson.
Oh, Deshaun Jackson.
Kirk Cousins had him. Man,
Kilpatrick connected with him.
Kilpatrick making what dude look like
Fritz Magic.
Any given Sunday with Jamie Foxx behind quarterback. He doing this with Jackson.
But you know what?
But yesterday, he was doing some shit. But then, you know, they came up on him. You know what I'm saying?
Now, that was Johnny Manziel, wide receiver, that was tripping.
But you know what?
Evans.
I'm going to say this, though. Minnesota has been exposed offensively and defensively. Bills ain't had a win since then, and they look like the worst team in the league. And they blew them boys out.
Cam Newton,
21.
I see you, bro.
They've
I see
been
you
exposed.
Out here. MVP, Cam Newton. Because he throwing it. I'm looking at Mitch. I'm like, I want to know, when he studied film, do we like kind of look at his other, quarterback, guys that's in the league and say, you know what, Dad, I like how he do this. You know, as a basketball player, you go to the playground and be like, hey, hippie, man, how you do that step back jump shot? Show me that form. Do he do that and watch film and say, man, like Cam, like you are running like me and you tall like me, like how you do that? What you doing? Cause he making them running back from Stanford look nice.
Nah, but you know what? That's the quarterback thing, and sometimes he might be doing that and asking and inquiring about that information.
Cause he not you big.
But the coaches might be giving him something else, because this offense looks very collegiate, and it's like collegiate is not gonna get you to the Super Bowl.
But when Cam was at Auburn, he ran a similar like that. You know what you call that?
The spread option.
The hand off and throw it. Cam has mastered that.
Yeah.
I mean, he took a team to the Super Bowl with no help, just doing that. And you can't stop him running, and you can't stop him throwing.
Right. Because at that point,
that's what you should be watching, not Drew Brees. Drew Brees is under center.
Because at that point, you're a dual threat. But the thing is, you can also give looks. Because it's so predicated on a gimmick and a scheme that you could give them a different look. So it's like, if he's not sure, those quarterbacks keep the ball a run. And then that's when you're on them, because now you're beating up on the quarterback a lot more.
And that's the offense he ran at. The same offense he ran in North Carolina is the same offense Cam Newton runs every day in his career since he's been in the NFL. And he's the best at it.
Absolutely.
Why is he watching Drew Brees when that's who he should be watching? Cam is winning, opening up his chest, Superman. He hitting people on 50-yard punches from Michigan, making him a star. Like Drew Brees is making Thomas a star. Like, who is Mitch Trubisky making like look good? If it wasn't for Mac,
right?
We wouldn't be having this conversation, even though the Bears in first. And like I said, I'm not trying to tell down Mitch. If you listening right now, I'm not trying to tell you down. What I'm trying to tell you is that watch people that suit your game.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Kobe didn't watch Clyde Drexler. He watched Mike.
So
I think that defense still would have been straight. I mean, I'm not saying that Mac ain't, what he is. I mean,
Mac is the best defensive player in the world.
But that defense was already up and coming. So I think that defense was going to be, showing out anyway.
Not like this. They winning games.
Saying they was going to win games.
Let's move forward. Let's talk week 3. All the games that didn't happen, we got to talk about it. First, we got the Jets and the Browns.
I didn't know Baker Mayfield was coming. If I would have knew,
I didn't.
And the
see
Jets
it coming.
Neither.
But Jets didn't know either.
We all took the Browns.
Yeah.
But you know what? It was the thing is, I think that somebody they saying now that Ty Haley was like calling some BS for Tyrod Taylor, and he was on point with Baker Mayfield. But it's like it goes back to like that Trubisky and his whoever's back up.
He a vet though, right?
Yeah. Tyrod Taylor was hesitant to throw the ball, whereas Baker came in and he just said, fuck it, and started throwing that bitch, and it's like,
and that's how he was.
That electricity and that buzz got to go, and that carry.
Swag. He got that Jamie Foxx in him.
So, Bills Vikings 27-6. We already talked about that.
Big up Troy Evans, man. He had like 12 tackles that game.
Giants Texans. I took the Giants.
Saquon Barkley, my jersey coming in the mail.
I took the Texans, thinking my man Deshaun Watson was going to come to life.
Me too, though.
I deserve to tell him.
Hold on, which one of y'all was arguing me about Saquon Barkley? That was CL. CL, I told you, what you talking about, Todd Gurley? Saquon Barkley, boy.
So, then we up next, we got Packers Redskins. I picked the Redskins.
I picked the Packers.
I didn't see that coming, but big ups Adrian Peterson.
I didn't know Adrian Peterson played for the Redskins until Sunday.
Yeah. He had, 31 carries, man? And what pisses me off is...
And I like the quarterback. What's his name?
Alex Smith.
Smith. I like Smith.
Chicago, take notes. They beat the Pack ass.
Adrian Peterson had 19 carries for 100
something, right? Yeah.
I know he was like 10 yards
a carry. Two touchdowns.
10 yards a carry, pretty much.
What? Man, he looked good. First of all, I didn't even know he played on the team until Sunday, so... But he looked good.
Yeah, AP most definitely looked good. Then we got 49ers and Chiefs. Smokey D team.
I picked them at Mahomes. 13 touchdowns, no interceptions. That boy is an
animal. He got one interception.
He got one. Yeah. Every day is Halloween. That boy is a monster.
You know the thing is, though, I'm still disappointed with that defense, though.
Yeah, that defense horrible.
All right, man. We know y'all defense is the shit.
No, it ain't about our defense.
We
talked about this.
Look, they got rid of Peters.
Wait. Let me say what I gotta say. But we talked about this. Yeah, you're gonna buy this one for $1. But but we talked about this yesterday. I told you, I said that defense gives up too many goddamn points, and can this young boy keep up putting up them points like that throughout the season? I think not. I think their arm is going to burn out. I think things are going to start to slow down. And they're going to be the Kansas City Chiefs just like last year. Started off hot, ended cold.
You think they won it done in the playoffs?
Yeah.
With Mahomes and the backup?
Yeah.
That remains to be seen. But right now, he muy caliente.
Hey.
I can't
say enough about the kid.
Down. I ain't saying he ain't a bum.
I chose 49ers this game. The game was sort of close until Jimmy G got hurt in the fourth quarter, and it'll be interesting to see how it would have progressed. But hey, Kansas
City,
he done
for the year too. I saw the news.
He done for the year, and that's another thing about you can't run through that brick wall. Sometimes
you have to play smart.
That was a tough break. $137 million.
But he guaranteed 70
for 2018.
Hey, enjoy your early vacation, baby.
Then we got Dolphins and Raiders. I picked the Dolphins.
That was like a trick game. Both of them bum ass teams, but
you know what?
You mean the Dolphins 3-0?
They is.
Yeah.
Adai ain't that no more, right?
No.
They got some power rankings got them at the 10th best team in the league right now.
No.
Well, you 3-0, you can say that.
The Dolphins over there balling with Tannehill.
Yeah.
Oh well, he a quarterback. I didn't know. You know, they lost the dial in his running game. I don't know who the running back.
I don't know
nobody on their team but Tannehill.
Frank Gore.
Oh, I thought he was in Indiana.
I guess he got traded.
Indiana ain't got no team. What the hell wrong with Lack, man?
Hey, man, I don't know what's going on, man. This is beyond me.
But Adam Gase has he's a very good game planner offensively. So that game in Miami and Chicago is – became that much more interesting.
Ah, well, them too.
And then we go to the Colts and Eagles.
Speaking of Indiana.
You know what? I picked the Colts to win that one, and I was looking good for a minute. Then I forgot Indianapolis can't stop
MVP
nobody.
Carson, MVP wins.
Who said that?
Carson. He won.
Oh, Lord.
So then we got Titans, Jaguars, they won.
I picked the Titans, but what's he got? Mariota got hurt again?
Yeah, he did.
Damn, he did.
That boy, man, he only good for 9 games.
You know what?
He go 9-0, and they lose the rest.
Those,
and they make the playoffs.
Those are the type of games that keep Blake Bortles on the outside of from tier 2 to tier 1, because you're supposed to win games like that. 9-6 is that's a very
difficult. Oh, the Titans won?
The Titans won.
Oh, I picked the Jaguars.
I picked the Jaguars as well.
Yeah, I picked the Jaguars.
I thought I picked the Titans.
It was a lot of upsets this week.
No.
Did I pick the Jaguars or the Titans?
Everybody picked the Jaguars.
Dang, I'll never go against
Bengals and Panthers. I picked the Bengals. That was a lot.
Boy, you tripping.
Hey, the Bengals was hot.
Go against Cam Newton. Put Bengals pat in your head.
You know what I call him, right?
The hot wave,
I call him Killer Cam, man.
Cam, I can't go against Cam. I don't care. Every week they play, except against the Bears, I'm picking Cam.
But you know what? People sleep on, like, Julius Peppers back at defensive end instead of outside linebacker is still playing. Luke Kuechly. Hey, best linebacker in the football right now, man.
Broncos, Ravens.
Didn't see the Ravens beat their ass.
I picked the Broncos.
And the Ravens won, right?
Yeah, I picked the Broncos.
Hey, Lamar Jackson, hang in there, baby. If you listen to Lamar, hang in there, baby. I'm still ordering your jersey, too.
Lamar Jackson.
You and Saquon.
Lamar Jackson need to be in a Bears uniform.
Yes, he
does. Nah, he should have been in the Cardinals uniform. I don't know what they was thinking taking Rosen over him. Man, what's wrong with these people picking the people?
He said picking the people.
Goodness, man.
Then we move on. Saints and Falcons was finished in overtime with Drew Brees lunging over and getting that final touch.
Drew Brees! Did you see Drew Brees run? Spin! Two people ran into each other and he got in the end zone. Drew Brees, man, if you not first ballot Hall of Fame, man, they tripping off.
He better be
off.
That was
all.
And then with the game on the line, he jumped. He sacrificed his own body for the team.
Yeah.
That, like, man.
And this is an up in age Drew Brees.
He was like 39, 40 years old now.
He's up there.
I was a freshman his senior year at Purdue.
Yeah.
So I'm 36, and he 3 years older than me.
Yeah,
at least
about 40 then.
Yeah, at least three. Yeah.
Damn.
But Drew Brees.
And he's not great, but Aaron Rodgers is.
Who said he not great?
A lot of people say Aaron Rodgers is much greater than him.
Somebody who don't think Drew Brees not great, please call in right now.
And kill yourself.
Then we got Rams and Chargers.
Oh, that was easy.
You know what?
The Rams got an all-star team.
The Rams
they got
came
a
out. But you know what? The Chargers did have some turnovers, man. So, and the Rams,
they like that wide receiver for the Chargers. He nice.
Oh, yeah. I think I know what you're talking about.
He got like that movie star name.
Keenan.
Keenan something. Yeah. Allen.
Keenan Allen. Yep. Keenan Allen is definitely
nice.
A baller.
Then we got Bears and Cardinals. We talked about that.
They are who we thought they were.
Then we got Seahawks and Cowboys. I took the Cowboys.
I thought they was going to keep giving it to Zeke.
You know what? It's hard to go against Seattle in that dome, man. And I went with Seattle. It's hard to go against Seattle.
Fuck Jerry and them Cowboys. That's Prescott ain't the man. He ain't, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh, he's the new improved this
give
and that.
Give the ball to Zeke. Just like the Bears need to give the ball to Howard.
Give the applehead ass nigga the ball, yeah. Zeke.
You can't stop Zeke, man. The man just can't be stopped.
That's a hell of a line they got there, isn't it, son?
Yeah.
Man, if Zeke was anywhere in the world, he gonna do what
it's a combination? Dedication to the run. It's a discipline to the run. You're going to say, no matter what, we're a running football team.
That number four throw
and our offense is going to be predicated off that.
But don't they have supposedly had the best line in?
Yeah, because they run the ball.
But they don't run the ball.
Yeah, but here's the thing: when you have the best offensive line, it's more predicated on running the ball because
of course.
If you go back and look, when it's time to pass. You so you that's what the play action pass
Troy
come
Aikman,
off.
Though.
No, he's not.
He can't
when it's time to pass, that's why they run the play action so much because they're so used to an offensive line coming and beating them up. Even in pass protection, you're allowed to take that one step forward, and so it's like instead
LeVar
of rushing the passer, you have to stand your ground first.
All I'm saying, LeVar, is this: Ezekiel Elliott was over there in Indianapolis. Would he be doing the shit he's doing now?
Hell yeah.
Zeke.
Y'all really believe that?
Yeah.
Zeke is a special talent.
He's just that dude.
Zeke is
man.
A nice running
Zeke
back.
Zeke is
he's
a special
that
talent.
You if better, Barry Sanders was in Indianapolis,
you better
he'd kill.
You better respect that Big Ten, man. But,
Saquon.
The Lions.
I order your jersey.
Patriots and Lions.
That shocked me. Lions on two, one doing nothing all week for the first 2 weeks, and then, you know, Tom's.
What happened?
I think people get up
Brady
and play them,
said
man.
That
I think people get up to play them.
They like going to State and Cleveland with LeBron. Like, people, they go to sleep at night and eat good breakfast for them.
You know what? Patricia was like, you know what? I was telling you because, like I told you, this Belichick-Brady beef is real. And I think he was like, you paying the people that you like. We're slow at the linebacker position. Lions came out and they utilized them speed backs to put them linebackers to work, and they could not keep up with them boys. And that's how the Lions end up running away with this game.
Then again, the Colts did was a defensive coordinator down there with the Pats.
That is true.
Yep, that is true. And who knows how to attack that defense than the guy that was coaching them for 16 plus
year
16 plus games last year, and you did not improve that defensive unit not one bit.
Not to mention
Gordon played.
Not to mention Kerryon Johnson burned their ass for 100 plus yards.
Yep.
What number 21 play for the Patriots? Is he still with the team or they let him go?
He's with Tennessee, Malcolm Butler.
Butler, yeah.
He's with Tennessee now. And the guy Rowe, I'm still waiting on him to shut down somebody because Belichick swears up and down that Rowe was a better cornerback than Malcolm Butler, who won you a Super Bowl. And you can also say that Rowe cost you a Super Bowl because most of the touchdowns that Philly scored was over Rowe. I got that Belichick vouched for. Let that sink in.
So we moved on to the we're gonna move on to the last game. Steelers and Bucks. What you call him? What you say your homie called him? Smokey D.
Fitzmagic.
Fitzmagic.
He was snorting that shit too at halftime. Hey,
he wasn't pulling the rabbit out of his hat early.
Shit.
Now Fitzpatrick, he finished with 411, 3 touchdowns and 3 interceptions. Mm-hmm.
You know what? I was thinking about that game. On the way over here, he looked like shit in that first half. They had his number. They put the pressure on him. He was
he had no run support. That's why
he pulled off his mask. I seen Jay Cutler with a beard. You know what I'm saying? The beard game.
That second, like Conor McGregor, man.
That second half.
So it was Jay Cutler under that mask.
Yeah,
he pulled off his mask.
It was like an episode of Scooby Doo or some shit like that, man. they caught the killer and shit like that. But that second half, Pittsburgh do what championship teams do. And they laid back, didn't give up nothing deep, kept everything in front of him, and he started hitting his pass.
And he got his confidence up.
And he got his confidence up and almost got him back in the game, but the damage was already done at that point.
Yeah, because they stopped running. It was 3 and out in the lot. And then, so they didn't even really have the ball that much in the second half.
No.
Pittsburgh. And then Roethlisberger made all the plays he needed to make and won the game.
Yeah, he had to remind me. Yo, you notice Mark went 17 straight completions at one time. I'm like, I don't take nothing away from Big Ben. I just said the man's getting his step, you know what I'm saying, to that rocking chair. Exactly. But
man, he was 30 for 38.
Big Ben was?
Yes, he was.
353. This is why I like Big Ben, because Ben is very – listen here. This is not a rare thing when Ben goes on a 7, 10, sometimes 15 plus completions in a row. Like, seriously. Like, during a game, it don't be happen one time during one series. No, it might happen about maybe 2, maybe 3 times during the game.
Yeah.
In different series. Big Ben is a very accurate quarterback, and I don't understand why people don't give him the proper respect. How's Aaron Rodgers great over him?
He got 2 Super Bowls.
Yeah.
And the numbers don't match up.
And here's another thing about Big Ben. People forget how strong he is as a quarterback.
Remember, this is a quarterback.
He's
a shove, like, defensive lineman off of
him. He is the same size as defensive ends in this league.
Oh, speaking of which, you talking about shove. What the hell was Chris Connie thinking? Stepping his ass up there. Because he's like, who is that? I said, you know it's Chris Connie.
For the Bears.
Who?
Conte, they used to play for the Bears.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Hold on, hold on. Chris Conte is not new to getting his ass treated. Because with the Bears, he used to get beat on touch. I just saw him get ran over. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, boiled over, like, boom. He laid out flat like he was getting crucified.
He undertook to pick him up, though, and chokeslammed him in the game and kept winning.
He gave him a 2-piece without barbecue sauce, man.
Oh, my God.
He gave him a 2-piece
Conte, baby. Hey, that's you messed up.
He threw his ass like when you want to get a irritating bitch out your face. Get out, motherfucker!
He muffed the shit out of that ass.
Nah, he choked
my face, man.
He put the handprint all right here in the hell.
Man,
Chris Conte, you gonna forever be a me. You forever gonna be.
Oh boy, you gonna be mean all day, boy. Conte gonna be mean, seriously,
man.
Hey, CL, find that Conte mean, baby.
I think he might be number 2 behind somebody else I know in a topic later on we're going to talk
about. Yeah.
Number 2 behind us. What you talking about? Oh, okay.
Oh, God.
We're going to go on ahead, man. We're going to get into a music break. When we come back, man, we're going to talk a little bit of NBA. Be back in y'all. Yeah.
1-2. Check me out right here, yo.
Yo, the sun don't shine forever, but as long as it's here, then we might as well shine together. Better now than never, business before pleasure. P. Diddy and the fam, who you know do it better. Yeah, right, no matter what, be airtight. So when you hear something, make sure you hear it right. Don't make an ass out of yourself by assuming our music keeps you moving. What are you proving? You know that I'm two levels above you, baby. Hug me, baby, I'ma make you love me, baby. Talking crazy ain't gonna get you nothing but choke. And that jealousy is only gonna leave you broke. So the only thing left now is God for these cats. And babe, you know you're too hard for these cats. I'ma win cause I'm too smart for these cats. While they making up facts,
in a commission, you ask for permission to hit him. He don't like me, him and wild wife, he was with him. You heard of us, the murderers, most shady. Been on the low lately, the feds hate me. The sun is, they say my killing's too blatant. You hesitating, I'm in your mama crib waiting. Duct taping, your fam, destiny lays in my hands. Gat lays in my waist. Francis, M to the is H phenomenal. Gun rest under your vest, body abdominal. Rhyme a few bars so I can buy a few cars. Then I kick a few flows so I can pimp a few hoes. Excellence is my presence. Never tense, never hesitant. Leave a nigga bit, real quick, real sick. Wrong nights, I perform like Mike. Anyone, Tyson, Jordan, Jackson, action, back guns. Ridiculous, and I'm quick to bust if my ends you touch. Kids or girl you touch, in this world I clutch. Q-Auto, Matto. Used to call me Fatso, now you call me Castro. My rap flows, militant, y'all faggots ain't killing shit. Oops, Cristal, keep spilling shit. You overdid it, Holmes, you in the danger zone. You shouldn't be alone. Hold hands and say it like me, the most shady. Frankie baby, fantastic, graphic. Trying to make dough like Jurassic. Hopped in, pick the spark kids who start shit. See me, only me, the underboss of this holocaust. Truly yours, Frank White.
I got the real live shit from front to back. To my people in the world, where the fuck you at? Where my niggas is at? Where my niggas is at? Where the fuck my bitches at? Where my bitches is at? We got the real live shit from front to back. To my people in the world, where the fuck you at? Where my niggas is at? Where my niggas is at? Where the fuck my bitches at? Where my bitches is at?
Put your money on the table and get your math on. Break it down, split it up, get your laugh on. See you later, dog, I'ma get my stash on. There's a bag full of money that I get my ass on. I never lose the passion to go platinum. Said I live it up to all the cash gone. Ain't that funny? Only use plastic, crafted to make classics. Hotter than acid, PD, rolling on your tape of CD. The billboard killer, no team killer. The famo, ammo is every channel. We've been hot for a long time, burning like a candle. What you can do is check your distribution. My song's bumping Houston like Scarface the Booster. You ain't got it like me, you just mad cause I tell her how it is and you tell her how it might be.
We got this shit mapped tight, brass knuckles and flashlights. The heaters and the two-seaters with 2 meters. Senoritas, kiss rings when you meet us. B. Diddy run the city, show no pity. I'm the witty one, Frank the crook from the brook. Maddie broke the neck of your coconut. No respect, squeeze off to all y'all diminished. Shootouts for 20 minutes. Minutes until we finish, then it's to the loot, escape in the coupe, break bread with the kiss, Panero, chic loots, Black Rob, join the mob, it ain't no replacing him, niggas step up, we just macing them, placing them in funerals, criminals turn the vows to Brick City, nobody come off like P. Diddy, business wise, I play men, hide money on the island, Cayman, y'all just betray men, you spray men, opposition, competition, another day in the life of the commission, commission.
We got the real live shit from front. To my niggas in the world, where the fuck you at? Where my niggas is at? Where my niggas is at? Where the fuck my bitches at? Where my bitches is at? We got the real live shit from front to back. To my niggas in the world, where the fuck you at? Where my niggas is at? Where my niggas is at? Where the fuck my bitches at? Where my bitches at? We got the real live shit from front to back.
That's my Buster.
I'm playing that Victory because it's a Victory Tuesday.
Yes, sir.
Victory Monday.
On life.
We chilling, man. Sitting back, talking Chicago sports some more. Talked about the Bears week 3. What you say you want to move into, man?
Power rankings. Who your three top teams in the league right now going to power rankings?
Are we doing both or we just doing only power rankings?
We go both of them real quick. Just okay. Real quick.
Wait, why don't you go first?
Go ahead, kick it off.
So I'm saying you look at the top teams mm-hmm. in the league right now, a couple weeks in, week 4 already. Based on what you've seen, Who are your top, your three top teams in the league right now as we speak? Going from the worst, number three, to number one.
Okay. Oh, you want me to go first?
Yeah, you can go first, Lat.
Number three, I'm going to say in the NFL that I've seen from the worst to the best, number three I will say is I'm kind of torn between Carolina and Chicago.
Okay.
Number two, in the high NFL for number two, the Chiefs.
Okay.
And number one is that all-star team in LA, that Golden State team they got over there.
Yeah, can't go wrong. Can't go wrong. Smokey D?
Oh, man. I don't know how you said Carolina's number three.
Who beat them? And they got Cam. So that's what I said. The Bears got the best defense I've seen.
You ain't gonna get with this dude in Cam, man. So just make your picks.
He ain't learned that from a year.
I don't know. You ain't gonna win with this dude with Cam, man. Just let it go.
Cam, man.
We had a missed phone call too, but go ahead.
Cam over the Army. I'm taking Cam. All
right, I'll actually. All right,
that's number three. That's number three. Who you, what else you got?
I put three the Bears.
Mm-hmm. You put three the three number Bears.
Number two would be the Rams.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Nah, it's your team.
It's your pick.
I'm being biased, but number one would be the Chiefs.
Okay, well, all right. That's what it is.
All right, that's what it is. What about you, Key?
Oh, it's on me now?
Yeah.
I had a caller. We was going to get the caller.
We'll get him back in.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll get him back. Get my Adrian Bond on.
What up, twin?
Number three, of course. It's a toss-up between the Bears and the Jaguars. Because the Jaguars got a hell of a defense, man.
They the same team, man.
They basically are the same
team.
Really?
And
yeah.
They basically are the same team. But Blake Bortles know how to turn it on when they got it.
That's why I was saying
cause
that.
Because he unleashed on Tom Brady ass last week.
Yeah, he did.
And but I'm gonna go with the Bears at the number three. Number two, I like the Dolphins, man.
I know. What were you gonna say?
Really?
This underdog pick.
Oh, really? You like the Dolphins, huh?
Yeah. I like their freestyle of play. I like Tannehill. I like Tannehill balling, man.
Okay.
Everybody talk bad about Tannehill, but Tannehill actually ain't a bad quarterback. Listen here. Miami just has not had bad quarterbacks. They just had bad coaching because when Matt Moore was back there, Matt Moore was pitching big numbers too.
Yes, he was.
Loves Matt Moore too.
Thank you. Would you tell him? I've been on Miami, right? For some years. Because I like Matt Moore. I watch quarterbacks.
And they don't got like them superstar players. It's just a bunch of guys is going out there just getting a job.
Play football,
going
to play. Man. Yep. You know, Landry came from there. Adai came from there.
Is Landry still there?
Or no, he said Cleveland.
I like Miami at number two and number one.
Not they number three. Other than said number two. Okay.
Number one, Rams.
Yeah, they got an all star team.
I mean,
okay.
Rams is the most complete team in the NFL mm-hmm. right now.
That's true.
Dude spent money. He must have been golfing with the Golden State Warriors dude. Because he just said, you know what? Fine. If it worked for y'all, it's going to work for us in football.
Right.
Damn, Lack, man. Okay. Besides the defense, I mean, I'm not taking away from the offense, but you act like they had.
Should we name all the stars they got over there? They damn that dude.
War Moon is quarterback.
They do?
They got motherfucking man. Art Moon and slot receiver.
They do?
Listen here, Smokey D. The Rams are the most complete team in the NFL with a quarterback in Jared Goff, which I will roll with. I'm not going to lie to you. You got a stud of a running back. You got Woods. You also have, who else is over there?
The boy from Clemson that was a superstar. That was in Buffalo.
Sammy Watkins is with the Chiefs.
Yeah, Sammy Watkins.
Okay, I thought Chiefs, I was about to say the Chiefs.
I thought you knew that.
He was with the Rams, though, right?
Yeah, he was. Yeah, Cup.
Cooper Cup, yeah.
I mean, and on defense, we ain't even got a name.
Yeah.
I mean,
defense, they sick.
And they're a little banged up at corner right now, so that's going to be an interesting look for the rest of the year. You know, I have my picks, man, and I'm sitting up here, and it's like the top three is real tough. But right now, like I said, I got to put the Eagles at number three. The defense is keeping them in a lot of games, and now they got their quarterback back. So now they might hit that corner.
I don't think that's their quarterback.
You know, I don't think so either, but got to go back. What to see. Yeah.
See the franchise.
Number two, I'm going to go with the Rams.
For this season right now, I don't think that's their quarterback moving forward. Yeah. But right now, I don't think that's
the. Hold on, you said the Rams number two.
Number two, I'm gonna go
if
with the Rams.
You say Chuck Daly number one? I'm walking up this. I'm walking up this set and going home.
Oh, you just gonna quit on something like Vontae Davis, man?
I'm a fuck. Hey, if you say Chuck Daly, I'm retired. To
no, no, no. Go with the Rams, man, because they doing what they supposed to do, and they're looking damn good doing it. And number one, the Chiefs is looking damn good right now.
Y'all agree?
I thought they was gonna lose to the Broncos, which is a rivalry game that anybody knows.
We're playing to Monday.
Huh?
We don't play on the Monday.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That does come up the Monday. They played. I think they, who they played?
They played the Chargers.
The Chargers.
Pittsburgh, where everybody kept saying, "Oh, you know, y'all can get."
Nah, the Chargers is the team I thought they was gonna lose to.
And
sorry.
We played San Francisco.
Nah, the Chargers is the team I thought they was gonna lose to.
Yeah, Pittsburgh Monday night, right?
Nah, but they
bro,
shot it out
got
though.
Broncos. Yeah.
They got the Broncos.
Nah, when they
that's
played,
a rivalry game, that's going to see how well he's tested because everybody else that's played are already playing rivalries, or even this week because the Rams got to play Minnesota, which is going to be a test.
We got a 12-pack bet going on too.
Oh yeah,
me and Smokey D.
And the second part of the question to wrap up the NFL is they already got the odds out for MVPs. Like so your top three MVPs. This year,
right now,
based on you seeing
week three
from worst to first,
not Aaron Rodgers.
Number three, I'm gonna go Mac.
Okay,
Mac number three. Two, I'm gonna go Rodgers.
Okay,
and one, I'm gonna go Mahomes.
Can't go wrong now, Smokey D.
You want a drink? Eat a drink right up.
Man,
I don't want nothing but you drinking.
Damn. Number three is hard as hell.
It is.
I could have went Cam.
Now, here's the thing with MVP. That it traditionally goes with the offensive player. And so I'm opening it up. MVP of the league.
I mean, I'm looking at, man, who done made that impact on that team or, man, is getting that team to really, man, play the well. And right now, I mean,
Newton.
I put my boy Mahomes at three.
Mm-hmm.
Damn, can I put a whole defense over there?
If it was possible, Reeves. Man, but that's an individual award.
All right, number two. Damn. I get a running back over there, the Rams.
Ty Gurley. Can't agree with you more.
But number one, I'll give it to Mac because he didn't, man, totally.
Holmes, right?
No. You said offense, I'm giving defense. Man, he just, I mean, look, like we said, the defense was good, but he went over there, and now, man, they feel like they just, man, we're going to kill everybody. You know what I'm saying?
You talking about Matt Ryan or Matt Holmes, the one in the Chiefs?
He talking about Khalil. Motherfucking
oh, Khalil
Mack.
Mack. I thought he said Matt, like M-A-T-T.
Mack.
Mack.
Okay.
Hippie.
Number three, I got to go with Mahomes. No question. He,
okay.
He balling. Number two, that's a tough one. I'd probably go with Drew Brees.
Okay.
Number one, got to be Khalil Mack.
Okay.
He outperforming the Raiders by him damn self.
Yeah, yeah. Y'all trading
them. Damn, Skippy.
Y'all give a coach $100 million, but not a player.
You know what? We on the same wavelength. Number three, I'm gonna give it to Cam Newton.
So you give a coach $100 million, but not a player.
You know what I'm saying? Oh yeah, you shit. Just
what type of system that made?
I got number three for Cam Newton. I like the way he's playing. He's always a dual threat, and he's doing good on my fantasy team. Number three, just because of the record. I got to give Patrick the record, and the way I see that ball come out of his hand, Patrick Mahomes, man. That thing comes out like a gunshot, and it's accurate, and it's like he knows where he's going with the football. Like, I like the kid. The kid is something special to watch. But number one, it's Khalil Mack, and I'm going to tell you the reason why. They're making an emphasis on roughing the passer this year. He hasn't been called for one roughing the passer. This whole Chicago defense hasn't been called for one roughing the passer penalty yet this year. he's mastered the art of rushing the passer without really sacking the quarterback, without sacking the quarterback, because he registers two sacks with the strip, the strip sacks. He registers, you know, two times. He's outperforming the Raiders defense by his damn self, as Black Hippie said. And then let's look at everybody else he's playing with. Everybody else, people don't realize, Hakeem Hicks has three sacks already.
Yeah, for sure.
Eddie Goben has two sacks. Waquan Smith has two sacks. Danny Trevathan has three sacks.
I mean, Hicks, though, man, was that number last year, though.
But the thing is, everybody's level of play has increased. Prince because got his this first man,
pick six.
That's MVP. And here's another thing. The man is getting double and triple team, and he is still getting pressure.
Yeah.
Like, that is MVP caliber.
That motherfucker you need to talk to is Kyle Fuller, man. He needs to put his hands up like he's Jake Jettikus or some shit.
Well, you know what? Here's the thing. We say that about Kyle Fuller. Look at the quarterbacks. It was only two plays we talk about. Look at the quarterbacks. One against Aaron Rodgers, perfect pass. One against Russell Wilson, perfect pass.
That one with Russell Wilson, man, dude didn't even turn around. I'm like, what are you doing, fam?
Can we get Earl Thomas over here or no?
You could, but I think he's looking for a long-term deal. But Eddie Jackson is looking good.
Yeah, he is.
Eddie Jackson looked good last year. He's a ball. He is every bit the ball hawker Earl Thomas is.
I like Eddie Jackson from Alabama. But we're going to go ahead. We're going to get to music break, and we're going to finally get into NBA.
Yay.
And maybe.
Yay.
The last topic, Bill Cosby, man.
Well, we might save it tomorrow.
Be back in y'all here tomorrow. But we're going to be back in y'all in a minute.
These broke
niggas talking about. Say
again. Yeah. Saturday. Bueller. 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 Slow me. I came here with nothing. Now I want it all. Left out the trap with a sack. Now I'm about to ball. And this is the move. The mood that I'm in, fuck these broke niggas talking about. Say again, shit, I feel like the man. That's the mood that I'm in, the mood that I'm in. Fuck these broke niggas talking about. Say again, I got mine about the mud. I don't owe nobody shit. Matter of fact, I take that back. It's a couple boys, I owe at least a clip. Cause you tried to set me up, and you was gonna go and snitch. And I hope you still on with that work you ran off with. Boy, don't think I'm gonna forget. Yeah, fuck who you going get. Do you know who you going against? Shit, all of my brothers and folk on the hustlers, you know who I'm coming with. Yeah, the feds like say again. The plug on his way again. I've been trapping so long, I done lost track of time. I'm like, damn, what the day again? Shit, I don't get no sleep. I've been paranoid all week. Yeah, your new bitch, my old friend. Man, got that hoe on a long leash. Yeah, and I'ma just clue you in. I'm gon' hit that shit again. And when I get done jumping out of that pussy, just hope you don't fall a bit. I came here with nothing. Now I want it all. Left out the trap with a sack. Now I'm about to ball. And that's just the move. The mood that I'm in. Fuck these broke niggas talking about. Say again. Say again, shit, I feel like the man. That's the mood that I'm in. Fuck these broke niggas talking about. Say again, shit, I'm flexing with bad attention. Smile on my face the whole fucking time. Count it up like a statistician. I see a small face and I'm mortified. Look, I make dirty money, I blow dirty money till police is notified. Yeah, I'm selling that hard, I'm rapping this hard. Models getting too excited. DM what they wanna do in profit. Talk that dirty talk to me, baby. Long as you can back it up, I do not mind. But this paper got my undivided. So you thoughts getting uninvited. Cause it's money over these bitches. It might be the summer rap. Flyest nigga in the room. These hating niggas ridicule. Can't get no money. Now they gotta get into them. I'm just getting cake up. I came here with nothing. Now I want it all.
left out the trap with a sack. Now I'm about to ball. And this is the move. The mood that I'm in. Fuck these broke niggas talking about. Say it again. 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 Shit, I feel like the man. That's the mood that I'm in.
Bring your A-Game Sports Talk Radio mixed with a little bit of live and direct. Down here with the players. My 20 plus year homie Smokey D.
Even though you're trying to treat me right now.
How, man? What are you talking about? Man, whatever. Anyway. Then my Big Ten homie.
Oh, I'm here.
Tim Young.
Yes. Big Ten, I'm proud of you. You made me proud. You heard me on the show.
Then we got Chicago.
Download Spreaker.
LeVar Hammond.
Oh, yeah, man. Like you said, Big Ten, man. You
know? I'm so proud of them. Thank you.
Man.
They listening to us.
I'm your host, Black Hippie.
I wish they wake up, man. Like some cats like Royce I know, so.
So, we're going to have the homie Shoe Bob Benny down here this Saturday. Shout out to the homie Smokey D for setting that up.
If I'm free, I'll come down.
Yeah, come on through. Going to have
come
him
all the way
down.
Out the Addison Trail.
Have a Shoe Bob Benny just play right there. Mood. He got an album. He had an album that just dropped, right?
Right.
So, he had an album that just dropped, man. And, you know, as soon as Smokey D hook up with them, man, and get him connected, man, we're going to have them songs, man, so y'all can hear more of a Shoe Bob Benny right here from Chicago. So, keep supporting your people, man. Keep supporting you people. But we're moving on to NBA basketball.
Oh, yeah.
What you got to say about NBA basketball?
We want to talk about our predictions. Preseason is here. I mean, you guys have been watching sports on the NBA TV, internet, whatever. Anything you can be in front of, everybody's excited about basketball season. We want to just talk about, like, three quick things about our prediction, what storylines we're looking to follow, and we want to talk about who our surprise team is going to be this year. So starting off with the Final Four, who we think will who do we think will make it to the Final Four? Hip, I'ma be you. I'm gonna be an underdog picking person. Rico, I'm on my Black Hippie mode right now. I'ma say Golden State against OKC in the NBA Finals. And in the Western Conference, I'ma say Boston against Philly. I don't think there's gonna be any upsets over there. Next.
That's interesting.
I think Houston and L.A. losing.
I think it's Golden State, L.A. Mm-hmm. In the Western Conference Finals. And in the East, Boston most definitely going to be there.
For sure.
I got to see how Toronto do with Kawhi. But knowing Kawhi, I got to give Kawhi a little nod. If he come back being the same Kawhi, they could be there in the Eastern Conference Finals. But you can't forget about Milwaukee. Milwaukee Knights. That East, I don't know. I'm just saying Boston against whoever.
Boston against whoever.
Boston
against the world, the T-shirt they be having.
Yeah.
Boston against everybody.
And Philly's supposed to be trying to acquire somebody, too. I forgot who they trying to acquire, but... Philly, I don't trust them.
Season I can two. Understand why.
I don't trust them season
two. It's something about them too, but I'm going to still pick them.
They caught them by surprise last year, but I don't think season two going to be as good.
Right, right.
I can understand why. Oh. It's something about them too.
Who up, me or Smokey D?
Either one.
I think it's going to be, I want to say Golden State and Houston again.
Okay.
Coming out the West.
No. Out Vegas
the,
got.
Out the East. It's going to be Boston. And I'm going to say Miami. I think. It's word that Jimmy Butler is probably trying to get on with Miami.
Holy Ghost real quick. What the fuck did you just say?
I said Miami. I said Miami.
Hey man, we need Sam Snead down here, man. What the fuck wrong with you, nigga?
I said Miami.
CL, call out. Oh my God, that be fucking amazing.
Of course he would, but hold on. I thought the East was gonna be wide open this year, so to speak, though.
You too open.
I mean, it's talk that Jimmy Butler is leading towards Miami.
You like a 50-year-old thought trying to get married. Boy, you too open.
Now, it's talk about Jimmy Butler going to Miami.
That might we've been talking about far.
Miami has a lot of other set pieces in place, and if you're talking about them going up against, say, like a Philadelphia,
what set pieces?
I'm talking about like Dragic and what's the other dude from, that played
Tyler.
Tyler, it's another dude.
Whiteside?
Yeah, with the hair.
What's his name?
I keep forgetting his name. Duke. You know who I'm talking about. Yeah. Winslow,
yeah.
I mean, they got some nice pieces down there, and you add Jimmy Butler to the mix. That's a nice defensive team, and I think Spoelstra can get them through offensively. And Hassan Whiteside can be a difference maker as a rim protector for that team in the playoffs.
Why do these people live on ifs, would'ves, and should'ves?
I saw Whiteside against that man from Philly last year, and he didn't want no part.
You just Jimmy Butler over there in Miami, and there's no talk about Jimmy Butler being in Miami.
It's talk.
Even if Jimmy Butler go, he's not even better than Antetokounmpo.
No,
they're not even better than that team. So
I mean, I thought
you was gonna say Milwaukee, but you went a step further.
Like you said, the East is probably gonna be the most competitive. We had this talk once before. You said this might be the first year that an 8 seed might go to the finals.
That's very much true.
And if the East is as competitive as you...
The Bulls could be the
East. Hold on. You're right. But if the East is as competitive as you say they are, it is going to be...
Let's not forget about Indiana.
I'm not forgetting... No. I almost kind of written Indiana off
Cleveland
because...
Cleveland still got some key Lance players without LeBron, though, too.
Now, I'm saying Lance Stephenson is in L.A. And that's why I'm kind of like... I'm not high on Indiana. Okay? But...
So, the Black Panther don't count.
Black Panther is nice.
Black Panther. He's nice.
Oladipo, yeah.
He's nice, but...
I mean, is Oladipo good enough
right.
to be Boston, a right. Boston boy here? Boston, Philly, Milwaukee, and Toronto.
Right.
Them, I think, your four. You got John Wall is number five because they don't get along. Him and Beal, they need to trade. They need to trade.
And then we talk about
probably get blown up this year.
They have to.
We talk about Toronto, but then like I said, I don't think Kawhi Leonard's heart is in Toronto. I think he
said he's gonna be.
I think he'll play good for himself because he's looking for that $200+ million contract max deal, he ultimately wants to go somewhere else in LA probably. So, I think that's what he'll be playing for. But for championships, no. And then if you traditionally look at players that come out of Pop's system in San Antonio and go somewhere else to be the man, it don't bowl well.
All right, my prediction
is for
this caller. Before this caller go in.
Okay.
It's Golden State and Houston.
Okay.
It's going to be Milwaukee and Boston.
Okay.
I see the Greek Freak even stepping it up even more notch with your boy out of the East. You know what I'm saying?
All right. We'll see.
Caller, you on the L. Who we talking to?
CL,
did you hear what he said?
I had to call
there. CL, did you hear LeBron?
CL
with the Metro PCS.
Yeah, man, right. Call's dropping.
He got a new Metro PCS.
Man, he went from Metro PCS to Primeco.
Let me take care of this. I'm a call. I come to tell in on y'all talking about basketball because I was playing on the football. Basketball wise, like y'all said, the East wide open. But after I thought that Yana was working out with Kobe, and he might come out and just be on beast mode, and it can be MML and. To me personally, it could be Milwaukee and Celtics in the Eastern Conference Finals. That'd be nice.
Not bad pick. Hey, Sierra, what you think about Miami going to the finals?
I don't see it. They can't let up.
That's what LeBron picked Miami to go to the Eastern Conference Finals.
That day way right out to the sunset. That shit over with, man.
Yeah,
hey, LeBron said Miami can possibly be in the Eastern Conference Finals.
If you flipped the toilet on
me,
though,
I most definitely did.
Of course, even though you said that the East is wide, how you gonna say the East is wide open and then I pick a team that nobody agrees with, then I get the toilet flush? That's what I want.
The East is wide open.
Indiana.
No. Stop it right there.
That's what I told him. I said you could have said Indiana or something, man.
Hold on. Indiana lost Lance Stevenson though to L.A.
And they still got that big fella.
Which one?
With the dreads from Texas.
Who was him?
The big man from Indiana. What's the big man name from Indiana from the Pacers? The big fella that's nice, super nice actually.
I know you're talking about the long boy.
Yeah, with the dreads.
And I think Thaddeus Young still on that team too.
Yeah, he is.
Thaddeus still there.
I can't think of his name right now.
He get a good 15 to 18. And
he'll
match up probably a lefty that can shoot, stretch the floor, and put the ball.
Oh, and they got Holiday little brother playing.
Hey, check it out. That motherfucker Thaddeus Young is like a Swiss Army knife, man.
Yeah, he is.
He can do anything. I like that.
Right, he like that utility guy.
I just don't trust Nate McMillan coaching though. Just like
he did a good job last year.
He did a good job, but he borderline Hoiberg ish.
Hell no, man.
Not even.
McMillan reminds me of Doug Collins, man. He'll take you there, but he can't get you.
I don't know what he's talking about. I guess he didn't
he's
watch.
Sleepy. He's sleepy.
I guess he didn't watch Nate McMillan when he was in Portland, man.
I see him as a player. I see him as a coach.
I'm talking about coaching in Portland.
He had talent in Portland. He had talent in Portland.
Portland was deep when he was over there,
exactly, man.
And he didn't really have no way.
He had talent in Portland.
That Brandon Roy and all the kept getting hurt. That was the only thing that was killing him.
I don't know what the hell Vi talking about, man. But
I don't know. I just want to call in and say, man, you know, as I couldn't make it.
All right, then.
I ain't get on the league. Y'all doing y'all thing, man. You won the pool this week, so.
Appreciate it, Twill.
You picked the underdogs this week, man.
I won the pool, man.
Hey, how many wins you get? I got
seven. I got eight. Vi got five. Lock got seven.
Dang, I thought I had eight.
Hey, we won that bad.
Nah, it wasn't that bad. Y'all took y'all losses. Y'all took y'all losses with the Dolphins against the Raiders.
Jacksonville.
And y'all took Jacksonville.
Yeah.
And it was another one. Hold on. Oh yeah. Everybody, all y'all took the Packers and I took Washington. So that's what edged it right there.
I didn't know what's the name played for Washington. I know now though.
Yeah,
you took the
Bucks and I took the Steelers. Me and Lack took the Steelers.
I'm not picking against Drew Brees.
Yeah, that was a good pick. That was still a big thing. I said on the show he's gonna come out there fighting like a fool, but they were hot, so it was kind of like us.
And they needed to win.
Yeah, they needed to
win.
Cause they locker room falling apart.
But, all right, then Joe, we'll holler at you.
Yeah, I need to go ahead, come back and stop playing.
They trading them.
All right, so I'll check out tomorrow.
All right,
Twin.
So we talking Mo, NBA basketball. So what's the storyline?
I think my storyline this season, you know, I'm not going to take yours because I know you want to talk about.
No, I'm going to go ahead, man.
Now you want to talk about Minnesota, so you're going to talk about your storyline. My storyline is going to be can Hoiberg bring out the best in the Chicago? Is that your storyline?
Hell no, shit. Hoiberg is nowhere near my storyline.
Okay, is Hoiberg gonna bring out the best in that 10 deep Chicago Bulls team that he got this season? Because with that Bulls team, they got the potential. If you coach them right, with all that talent and then how deep you are in every position, they could easily be five, and they might could sneak up in that top four.
I say six or seven.
There you go. But that's my storyline. Well, you deep at every position. You got a couple players that can play three positions. Holiday can play the 1-2-3. You got Valentine coming off the bench. You got shooters. You got baby Dirk Nowitzki over there, who's your franchise player. Marketing. Mm-hmm. You know, you got the boy from Duke that's, you know, just as like
Wendell
Carter. He's a 3-4-5. You know what I mean? If you want to play small ball, you still got a leader in Lopez over there. Like they got a team. They got a team over in Chicago. You got the boy from LSU who been scoring 40 for life. And that Bulls got him. I call him Lou Williams. What's his name? That was in the D League, averaged like 35, and he killed the summer league. He even killed when the Bulls brought him up last year.
Yeah.
What's his name?
I know who you're talking about though.
Went to LSU, played with Ben Simmons. Anyway, him. The score, little Lou Williams.
The dude that was dropping 40 for the Bulls.
Yeah, he got like a hairstyle like mine.
Oh, you talking about Blakely?
Blakely.
Blakely.
Instant offense. Baby Jamal Crawford, throwback. Lou Williams, he gonna get, if he step on the court, he got 20. You know what I'm saying? Mark 2022.
So he
off the bench.
So he got the potential to be a sixth man of the year.
Sixth man of the year potential.
Okay. So what you got? What your storyline is, Bob?
You know what? I think it's
what you laughing at?
Is AD gonna be on the move before the All-Star break? Mm,
that's a good one.
Because there's a lot of talk about him going to LA, a lot of talk about him going to some team in the East, probably either Philly or what?
Boston.
I heard when about a possibility of him coming to Chicago. I don't trust no damn Hoiberg, so I never entertained it.
Parker in Chicago this year.
Yeah, Parker mm-hmm. in Chicago.
Sonny Parker, son.
You know, but that's my storyline, because you got a lot of these players that's on the verge, because they say the 2019 free agency class is supposed to be crazy.
Wherever so, he go is going to tilt the NBA.
I want to see what moves are going to be made, and I think between him and Kawhi Leonard, that's the storyline you want to pay attention to, because that's going to dictate the free agency coming up next year.
Anthony Davis, if you go to Boston, that's going to tilt the NBA.
What's your storyline, Smokey D?
Oh, man, you know, I want to see how long this drama up here in Minnesota is going to last. First, who's going to win the Jimmy Butler sweepstakes? Because the owner said, no matter what Tim Thibodeau says, he's on the market, and I'm going to get this done. Man, like an instant ticket. Man. And then I want to know how long Thibodeau's going to be in there, because he's turning him into the Timber Bulls up there, you know what I'm saying? Grabbing all assets.
I think he's going to be there, but his position of power in that organization is going to change.
They're going to probably like strip that GM title from him and make him, either he's going to be the GM or he's going to be
It's only
coach.
One Popovich ever. Yeah. Everybody can't be Popovich.
But the thing with Popovich is he has different players that he can use, you know, to get him up in the hump. What's name's going back after eight?
But he controls.
Go on, dang, I'll take him. Joakim Noah, well, maybe, but Derrick Rose, I'll take him. Look, man, you got superior talent, man. You got raw talent up there. You got Anthony Wiggins. You got Carl Anthony Towns. Then you just went and got Jimmy Butler, and now he don't want to be up there. It's friction up there. Come on, man. You got a young squad up there, man. You don't start making them do what you made them doing with the Bulls when they were young. Don't start getting old ass players, man. Well, I mean, respect to them, but look, you got a talented young core that you're not using.
Right. And there's been talk about him either going to like New York, and there's been talk about Kyrie going to New York. There's been talk about him going. Charlotte is on the radar. Miami's on the radar.
Kyrie ain't going, man. I don't even
know. No, not Kyrie. I'm sorry, for Jimmy Butler, though.
Kyrie is interested.
Right.
But if he win a championship this year, do he go? Do he leave Boston? If he bring Boston a championship, do he leave Boston and go to New York?
He probably
because that's his dream team.
My storyline is the East is going to be much better than the West. That's my storyline.
That's a prediction.
But the storyline is going to be how the East is outdoing the West as far as like.
And the West got all that talent.
Oh, right, exactly.
I love Jokic, though. I got to get his jersey.
Okay, so I got a question now.
Jokic is
because since they redid the All-Star game, they say whoever the leading vote getter in the East is going to be
the captain.
A captain, and whoever the
captain is going to be Giannis.
I'm saying, you think it's going to be Giannis?
Yeah, it's going to be Giannis.
Giannis and Steph.
Yeah.
You think Steph is going to get more votes than
Giannis,
LeBron?
Yeah. Giannis.
You think he's going to get more votes than LeBron?
Yeah.
Out West?
Yeah, I think he is. But
I think so.
You got a lot of Golden State fans. Like
I mean, just Steph Curry fans.
I mean,
people love Steph.
Yeah.
But I think the East, this is Giannis. That's his throne right now. The East is his throne. Now LeBron held it down. Giannis can do the same thing. Even with Kawhi over there. Even with Ben Simmons and
Jason Tatum. Because Jason Tatum.
Even with Jason Tatum, he can sit on top of the East.
Okay.
Tatum got a better team.
Yeah.
But as far as like player wise, to run the East and say, damn, I got a matchup with this motherfucking playoffs. You know how I used to be with Jordan and used to be with LeBron. I think Giannis.
So you like the Reggie Miller right now when Mike left?
Yeah.
Damn, you call him Reggie Miller?
You know when Reggie Miller?
No, I know that.
That was the only thing holding Reggie back. Reggie was the second best player in the East during that time. Who was better than Reggie? Don't think Reggie just shot threes.
At that time?
Yeah, at that time.
In the East?
In the East. Who was the second best player or the second best two guard? Because right, Giannis has been number two behind LeBron.
What were you talking about? What years though?
The year Mike left.
We talking like
Reggie was, and Reggie said, "The East is mine," and he went to the finals.
Huh, you said, "Hold on." Was Mike left the first time or the second time? I got to be
the very first time.
Reggie did go to the finals. Hold on.
In 94?
He did go to the finals.
No, that was close to 2000.
He right. After 98.
He lost to Orlando, if you say the first time, I'm going to lean more towards Penny Hardaway.
Penny was a point.
But
he was the player. Yeah.
Penny wasn't on top of the East, though.
I was saying top guard.
Him and Shaq.
A top guard.
I'll give you guard.
Scotty.
I'm saying top guard.
I'm saying top guard, though.
But Reggie was the most experienced at the time. He had been a man of his team.
That's why I asked. I said, are we talking about guard-wise? We talking about wing player? Or we talking about overall player?
Pat Fingerword. Fingerword is way too a loss. And Reggie gave the boys 50.
Yeah.
But the motherfuckers end up going to the finals. I mean, they got their ass whooped by Houston, but they end up going to the finals.
In 95?
Yeah.
Allen Houston?
I got to figure the caliber player Mike was, man. He stopped a lot of motherfuckers.
From winning rings.
He stopped a lot of Hall of Fame motherfuckers.
From winning rings.
That's why we got these Care Bears.
Stop comparing him.
So who is y'all surprise team now?
I'm going to go Jokic.
You going with Denver?
Woo-hoo, I love number 15 over Denver. Team?
You know what? I love Denver too, but I'm a big Donovan Mitchell fan.
That's a good one.
Utah, man.
That's a good one. But you know what? To me,
The West is stacked. Every team that he goes against is gonna be cold-blooded killers out there.
If he
makes a name and they hover around that 5 and 6 spot because of him,
shit, man. What he did in the playoffs last year, man.
Can he go to the West Conference Finals? He got the potential.
I say semifinals.
He did semifinals
last year, though.
Man. I say semi.
Could he be LeBron?
It might be Indiana.
We in the 10 o'clock hour.
Yeah.
I guess we're going to do the live and direct tomorrow.
Yeah. I'll say Indiana.
Indiana?
Black Panther.
My team. See, motherfucking red. That's my surprise team.
Bulls. Yeah.
Wait. Why are you saying surprise team? This would be like, man, they're going to be over some of these motherfuckers. That's what I'm trying to do.
Okay, because last year, what did they look like last year?
In the first half, they did good until
Dunn damn near lost his fronts when he hit the float. That's when the season was over with. That's when Pax and them trashed everything, because you got to figure when that happened, it was on a 10-game winning streak.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And when he hit his teeth, it was just like when Derrick Rose blew his knee. Mm-hmm. The whole stadium just went quiet, like, oh, what the fuck? It's happening again.
Can I ask you three questions?
Go ahead.
Three questions.
Start off with one.
John Paxson still in charge?
Yes.
Godforman still in the organization?
Yes.
Fred Hoiberg still a coach?
No. I don't see him making a pass the halfway point of the season.
But I'm saying right now.
Right now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't. That's why I can't fully embrace.
Dude, they were balling at first.
I'm a Chicago fan. I love the talent. It's the structural part.
Let me say this. The reason why I picked the Bulls as a surprise team, because you seen with the main core people what they can put together and how they can compete with other teams, including the West, this NBA.
Oh, yeah.
And to Dunn, I forgot what team he was playing until he fell and he hit his teeth. Mm-hmm. And then they knocked him out.
Mm-hmm.
That's what halted everything. The Bulls could have made the playoffs, man. It's just that then you snatched Lopez out at the 50 game mark.
Yeah,
it was over with for him. You barely playing
they
him.
They went to tank mode.
That's how you know it was over.
You traded what's his name to New Orleans.
Who? Nico. Well, you know him.
And he balled out.
Him and Bobby Kane.
So let me ask you this, because this is an offer. They saying so Bobby. They were saying Bobby Portis, Denzel Valentine, and like two first rounders for AD.
I take it.
I
would keep Denzel Valentine and get rid of Zach LaVine.
Damn,
they just re-signed him. Well,
I don't give a shit.
Yeah, Zach LaVine, he
Denzel Valentine shows me more promise to this organization than Zach LaVine.
Okay.
I'll be honest with you. When he first came back last year, I was like, cool. I'm going to tell you what made me turn on Zach LaVine. When they played Anthony Davis, ironically, you talking about him. When they played that.
When they had Boogie Cousins.
They played that game, they went like the, yeah, like four overtimes or whatever.
Yeah, we stayed at him.
And Zach showed. He didn't show up at all.
And was scared.
Yeah.
And Rondo. I mean.
Hold on, don't get it twisted. DeMarcus Cousins didn't show up neither.
Yeah, we talked about that.
He choked.
He ended up fouling out. Yeah.
And they put it on his shoulders and he choked.
Yeah,
he
choked. Dude was screaming at the TV. Look at this nigga. Man, motherfucker, man.
I told you.
He ain't doing shit.
I told you.
He disappears in the front of this nigga's Houdini.
Listen here.
Stop turning to ashes and shit like that.
I called DeMarcus Cousins 75 cents. He only give you 3/4.
Oh, man.
And it's over with after that.
Yeah, I never said he was better than Anthony Davis.
They said, man,
Anthony Davis, the third best player in the world.
Hey, that's why I don't know why people putting so much stock into this dude, because he ain't coming back until January to go to state.
So he said that Anthony Davis put on that final stone for the Finley Gullet, man, and Zach LaVine started to ash away and shit, man.
And yeah. Zach LaVine is just, I don't know, I hope he do good.
Front runner.
I hope he do good. But we're going to go ahead and take a music break. We're going to come back. We're going to wrap it up. We're going to talk Bill Cosby tomorrow. I still got to get some more facts about this whole thing. Because from what I understand was that they really proved the shit that he did it. But anyway, be back in y'all, man.
Talk tomorrow.
Oh, Major, don't go. Young Guru, Just Blaze, Killer, Diplomats, Joel Santana, Jim Jones, Freaky Zeke, half a dash, killer, y'all niggas dreamed it, I've seen it, body warm, heart anemic, coke, a nigga steamed it, fiends, I leaned them, beam, I leaned it, guns, really beam it, really miss, what's really good, bikes, really a dream it, I'm a genius, Papadopoulos, never lean it, on your zenith, killer, bag me more mutts, they actually all ducks, caddy more trucks, it's daddy Warbucks, and you off in Annie, ma, take off your panties, see soft and sandy, yeah, let's get lost in candy, I got lost in Boston, Austin, Floss, and of course Miami, Reno, Nevada, sip Pino Colada, mama, seen all the Prada, I rock Maury, Phoenix, road to glory, seen it, you seen it. The game abuse it, it's pain and music. But this year remains the bluest. I get lame and lose it. Beef came to do it, aim to shoot it. Flames till your brain's the fluid. Y'all just kids, see what I just did? Take a couple bars off, let Just live.
Yeah, now that's powerful music, man. You need to pop something, roll something. Killer, we did it, man. I got your back forever, Dipset. In them lanes, we pop them sideways and drag them faggots.
Okay, we back in. Mommy, listen, ayo, lock my garage. Rock my massage, fuck it, bucket by eyes, cause for guys, golly, I'm gully, look at his galoshes, Gucci, gold, platinum, black collages, from collabos, ghostwriting for assholes, wanna use my brain to give killer mad dough, it's all good, increase killer cash flow, increase my fame, that's why I kill a smash hoes, you'll get side swipe, look at my life, first movie ever, murked out my car fight. And Poppy got jerked out of pies twice. Dip set, we working with five dice. C-Lo and Cracks, C-Notes and Stacks. I send bodies with read this note attached. Your youngest fuck with Boys in the Hood. Gave us son like Ricky from Boys in the Hood. On the couch bloody, old lady sighing. Wifey screaming, pissy little baby crying. Fucked up, man. Shit, there you seen it. Fam, man, you cherry claw. That mean you very soft. Gravy Mercedes, add the cranberry sauce.
Yeah, gangsta's ride, man. Flex, we got you, guns up. And all my ladies, man, the ghetto's a ditty. I need you, I want you. Oh, pop something.
roll something, get twisted, that's on Jim, nigga. Harlem, man, we here to stay, there's nothing left to say, man. Eastside, and it's for that lame man. Not safe.
Bring your A-Game Sports Talk Radio. We ain't gonna do live and break this time around. We're gonna do it, wait until tomorrow and break it on through for y'all. That was Diplomats. I really mean it. That was a powerful album.
I like the Diplomats, period.
The way you said that shit, man, that was Diplomats. I really mean it.
Man, you will.
You really mean it?
That was a powerful. You got to unmute it.
Jim Jones.
I got it. Hey, that was a powerful album, man.
And they had an argument about that shit working, man, about them against the Locks, man.
Nah, they got into it with Jay-Z and what's his name? Dame Dollar. Because Dame was over. Yeah. Dame Dash. Yeah, Dame was over the Diplomats. That's when they broke up. You know, that's what
they were doing. A lot of them were doing too much. You know, you get off of your own projects, you know.
Hey.
We came upon that time. We're going to wrap up the show. I appreciate the fellas for coming out. Talk it on the radio. We're live across the air. Y'all can catch this later on tonight. I'm going to go ahead and throw the finishing little content on there.
I'm going to share it on Facebook.
Who want to be the ranter? Who want to be the shout-outer first?
Shout-out to the Big Ten Conference.
There we go. Relax.
Thank you. You know, I was hard on the Big Ten. I was talking about them, how... like, disappointing the week was, how horrible it was. And Purdue, you upset a ranked team. Every team in the Big Ten, like, did what they were supposed to do. Congrats to the Big Ten Conference.
That was like shout out. Who next?
Shout out to, man, the job guys. I might not have one tomorrow, but I still appreciate coming down here.
Tommy!
Why you going to have a job tomorrow? That's another business.
Craig,
go ahead, man.
I mean, I could talk about it on the air.
Nah, man, it's your day off.
I don't stay off, baby.
But go ahead, man.
Yeah, I really am.
Man, my message for the day is...
Hey, man, could y'all leave LeVar alone, man? No, let him do what he do, man.
Hey, I don't believe you said message. I know you said rant or, you know, shout out.
I love you, LeVar.
He created a whole nother character with my message for the day.
He did just say message. I tried to ignore it, but y'all don't let it be known, man.
You know okay, what? Boys and girls, let's be quiet.
Yeah, pretty much.
Mr. Hamlin's neighborhood.
I'm missing my lax sweater. That's all, man.
That's it. That's all you need.
But you know what? Times are tough here in Chicago, man, and I can't say too much, but whatever comes out of this Van Dyke trial, I urge the people of Chicago to, if you're going to protest, do it in the most peaceful way possible.
You just don't want to work no damn overtime if they burn this motherfucker.
No.
What that is.
I won't work it. Don't get me wrong. I'll be a fool turn around free money. But now the thing is, I don't want to see nobody else with a mark or asterisk on their record.
Or get hurt.
Right.
Or get hurt.
Yeah.
Because you got a broken system. And the thing is, before we can make change, we have to change ourselves first. Because, believe it or not, these motherfuckers got a gun. We provide them the bullets by being as rebellious or defiant as we are. You're supposed to do it to a certain degree, but not out the gate. And sometimes that's the only opportunity that they look forward to. And this year alone, we counted probably 3 or 4 incidences in which it did happen. And in order to make these changes so we don't come across another Laquan McDonald or Trayvon Martin, we have to change ourselves, man, and teach our youth better, man. And we have to start there.
I got a question about that.
Let me say something. I can understand what you're saying, but I'm not going to totally put it off on the person that's the aggressor, because sometimes these police officers be in their own little world of bullshit. And they may do little things because they know they have the law. They know they have other people behind them that can support them more stronger than the victim. That's what I'm going to call McDonald, a victim.
Yeah.
And that's why this is going on for so long with this dude, with Laquan McDonald. So listen here. Let me tell you something. I can understand your message of what you have, but if malicious intent has been implied by that has been applied for years and years and years and years, it didn't work for Martin Luther King, and it ain't gonna work in this day and age neither. So my thing is like, hey, he get off, tear this motherfucker up. And that's my last shout out and rant that I'm gonna give. Tear this motherfucker up. You got some overtime. We'll be back on y'all
tomorrow. You just be safe, man. I just want to say that. You be safe out there, man. Shit.